军武大本营，欢迎大家来到我们的特别节目。我们今天在现场的是大家都很熟悉的262，这位是特种兵吴新磊。我们今天呢其实是环太平洋二，那我们这里呢还有一个位子一直空着，其实呢是待会儿我们会分别请到我们环太平洋二的导演还有一位主演，他们会到现场来跟大家交流一下。Monsters destroyed our cities, so we created monsters to stop them. But the war is just beginning. Jaeger pilots, help me save the world. Now let's get it done. Well, he's pretty big, huh? On my command, fire everything you've got. On up, Bill. 那《环太平洋一》两位都看过了，什么感觉？
非常喜欢，作为一个从小开始喜欢摆弄机甲的熊孩子，看到这个机甲在荧幕上呈现出那么逼真的效果，我十分的兴奋。
2013年的时候听说有这个环太平洋一的时候，跟很多战友一块儿，然后你看着那些五大三粗的剃着光头的肌肉发达俄罗斯人坐在电影院里面吃爆米花，然后就看得津津有味。所以说全世界的男性的就是处于20多岁30岁就都对这种机甲充满力量的这种，
女生也会喜欢，我也喜欢。我印象特别深的是里边那个小女孩，特别可爱，眼神特别无辜，记得吗？就是啊，虽然从头到尾都在打，一直在打，但是就那一点点东西会让你觉得特别的动心。
我就感觉我们不管是在一和二里面，我们人类都是渺小的，但人类智慧是有无穷的力量。那一里面刚开场的时候就是说什么，我们制造了机甲这样的怪兽去跟那些怪兽去打拼。其实我们人类，你看，它和变形金刚这个机甲啊，就是环太平洋和变形金刚之间最大区别。变形金刚它是外星来物，它是有自己的思维啊，有自己的那个东西。但是机甲这个环太平洋啊，还是我们由我们人类去控制的。
所以说我们在里面，跟怪兽来打，
对，是我们人跟怪兽来打，只不过把我们人的力量放大到无穷了。
不过你是真的驾驶过一个中国制造的初级？
对，我那个是进去要系上安全带的，系安全带，有各种那个仪表盘，然后后面还有副驾驶，它这和这个我们环太里面的不一样。
好了，说了这么多，也准备了好多问题要问他，我们现在就赶快把导演先请过来吧。
Hello,
导演您好，特别欢迎您能够来到中国，我们一直都在期待着您的这部电影。您这次带来的这部《环太平洋二》是一个什么样的故事？其实我们已经期待了很久，可不可以小小的先透露一下？
It's 10 years after the first movie, after the breach is closed. There's been no kaiju attack for 10 years, so humanity has had a chance to rebuild the Jaeger program from the ground up. And on the other side of the breach, the precursors, those nasty little bug aliens on the other side, have had 10 years to redesign the kaiju and plot their revenge. And this movie is all about the plan from the precursors on the other side of the breach to try to invade the Earth again and destroy humanity.
听说您也是一个机甲迷，然后您最喜欢的是哪种机甲？还有就是电影里的机甲的创作有没有受到以前的一些艺术作品的影响，比如说日本的一些动漫。
Yes, we were hugely influenced by anime and manga, and the shows that I grew up as a kid watching, Ultraman and Ambassador Magma and all the old Godzilla movies. In this movie, all the Jaegers are advanced, the designs are advanced, the technology is advanced. And if I had to pick one Jaeger that was my absolute favorite, it's Saber Athena. It's the orange Jaeger, because it has such an Asian feel, and it feels like it was taken straight from an anime.
就是在《环太平洋一》这部电影里面有一个机器人，有很多手臂，有我们这个三兄弟驾驶的中国元素的机甲。那在《环太平洋二》在您执导的这部电影里面，就是我看到就是没有这些机甲，再也没有国家和民族这块的特点了。您这样设计是有什么目的吗？
Yes, that is absolutely true. What I wanted to do is advance the Pan-Pacific Defense Corps into a truly integrated worldwide national, international fighting force. So I wanted to strip away the idea of it's a Chinese Jaeger with Chinese pilots or an Australian Jaeger with Australian pilots. I wanted the Jaegers to be the world's Jaegers and to be able to mix up the nationalities of the pilots. So it was truly the world coming together to fight a common threat.
我觉得这是一个很好的，因为是全球化了，就是对所有的民族呀、语言呀、我们的科技啊、技术这方面的，的的确确是需要融合到一起，成为一个大家庭，一起来战斗，对付那些怪物。
那您在设计这部电影的时候，您说这个机甲是有升级的，它在什么地方有升级？它厉害在哪里？或者说您把您的什么样的你童年的梦想或者您个人的一种想象融进去了，在哪些细节上，可不可以多举一些具体的例子？
Sure, absolutely. We wanted these Jaegers to feel like several generations later. Imagine the first movie, the Jaegers are the grandparents of these Jaegers. So some of the upgrades are the weapon systems. Gypsy Avenger has a gravity sling. It can reach out a gravity beam and throw cars or buildings at a kaiju. Saber Athena has twin energy swords that can combine into one big broad sword. So we wanted to incorporate those kinds of very interesting new weapons. And for me, I grew up watching Tokyo destroyed in monster movies and on Ultraman. So one of the things I really wanted to do in this movie is destroy Tokyo. Except do it with the advanced computer graphics technology in visual effects. And when you see this battle in Tokyo, it is one of the most thrilling, amazing action sequences for this kind of genre I think I've ever seen.
这部电影里面和上一部《环太平洋》的电影的区别在于，上一部电影大部分是单打独斗。而这部电影我是当过兵的人，所以说我能很清楚看到它有一个团队间的战术配合，是这样的吗？您为什么去这样设计呢？
Yes, there is some single combat in the movie. Particularly there's an evil Jaeger that Gypsy Avenger fights, a Jaeger called Obsidian Fury. For the final battle, I very much wanted it to be a group effort. I wanted it to be the four Jaegers fighting the three main kaiju. And it spoke to the idea of unity that I wanted to get across in this movie, that we are stronger if we work together.
环太平洋一的整体给我的感觉，我在看的时候是偏夜间，下雨，在水里面，就是又潮湿又黑暗。而导演他指导的《环太平洋二》，就是在大晴天，在一个很开阔、很明亮的一个环境里面去作战。对，这可能对我们的镜头啊、演员啊以及导演您的设计这方面，真的是一个很大的挑战。这其实也是能够让我们通过电影的画面看清楚那些机甲和怪兽真正的形状，这点是非常过瘾的，我觉得。
Yeah, I thought Guillermo del Toro did such an amazing job in the first movie with the action sequence being shot at night in the rain or underwater. I didn't want to repeat that or try to imitate that. I also wanted to give the audience something new and different. So we decided to have most of the action sequences during the day. Technically, it was a lot more difficult. It's a lot more difficult for the visual effects department to create these scenes during the day when you can see everything for miles. But visual effects has advanced so much, we were able to do it in the daytime this time around. And I think, like you said, you can see a lot more, you can see the Jaegers more clearly, the kaiju more clearly, and hopefully it'll be even more exciting for fans of the movie.
我特别关心一个大片是怎么样拍摄出来的，我们看到的一般是最后的效果，但是在拍摄的过程中会用很多的绿幕或者是蓝幕，会让演员去对着空气表演，然后还会有大量的后期去制作，就它对您来说是不是操作起来特别的难？就最难的地方是什么？
It is the visual aspects of a movie of this size. There's so many different pieces. But thankfully, I had an amazing effects house, Double Negative, and a fantastic visual effects supervisor, Peter Chang. That really helped me out quite a bit. For me, the most difficult part of the movie was trying to make sure that the characters and the story was as exciting as, and interesting as the giant Jaegers fighting giant kaiju.
可不可以分享一些幕后的故事？比如在拍摄的过程中，您觉得最困难的一场戏是怎么拍出来的？或者说最难表现的，你最精心设计的某一场戏，跟我们讲一下。
The most challenging sequence in this movie was the attack on the Shatter Dome by the kaiju drones. What made it so difficult was the other action scenes are between Jaegers fighting Jaegers or Jaegers fighting kaiju. And it's difficult, but it's self-contained because you've got two actors inside the Conpod. With this, I had 12, 13, 14 actors that had to run around on the ground while this attack was happening. So it was very difficult to manage everyone and make sure the shots with the live action matched the visual effects shots that we needed. That said, I felt like a little kid with toys. It was so much fun shooting this movie. Every day was just an amazing experience.
每天都很精彩吗？有没有过那个？
可是对于那些演员来说，他们穿着是真的穿着那身衣服，机甲的衣服，他们平均每天要在那身衣服里面包裹多少个小时的时间，他们会不会感觉很累？作为导演，您是有没有为他们想过？
They spent somewhere around anywhere from 10 to 12 hours a day in the suits, and they were hooked in to the mechanism, the arm mechanism, and we were on top of a two-story high hydraulic gimbal that shook the entire set all day. So it was very, very difficult for them. When you see them sweating in there, it's real sweat. It was really, really hard for them, but they did a magnificent job.
环太平洋2预告片发布以后，很多网友对片中机甲的形象进行了吐槽，觉得相比于环太平洋1，机甲的质感、重感还有舞台光影效果全都没有了。上了汽车的亮熙越拍越像变形金刚。而对于环2中的怪兽，有网友也表示看到了哥斯拉的影子。
刚才您也讲到一个细节，其实我在看预告片的时候也注意到了，就是让怪兽也来驾驶机甲。其实我个人来说，我觉得这样更过瘾，因为看到两个机甲打的时候，视觉上的冲击和那种很爽的感觉是加倍的。但是也会有人去提问呢，就说那这样的话，其实有时候会感觉像变形金刚的那种机甲打机甲的方式。那在您在处理这个情况的时候，怎么让它跟其他的那些很经典的作品去不一样，或者说表现出环太自己的特点？
I love the Transformer franchise. I actually worked on it for a bit. But the thing that really draws me to Pacific Rim is it's not just two giant robots fighting.It's the people inside these Jaegers. It's the soul inside the machine. And even beyond that, that it takes two people who have to work together to operate one of these Jaegers. I think that's what really makes Pacific Rim unique and makes it engaging for the audience. It's not just the visual effects of a couple of giant robots. You get to go inside and feel the emotion and the strain.And the effort it takes from the human element to operate these machines.
啊，我有一个观点，在中国有一个类型片叫动作片，非常受欢迎。那么，我觉得这种大型机甲的战斗，它其实是把战争片变成了一个动作片。
Oh, I totally agree with you. I agree 110%. I love action movies. I love kung fu movies.And I love the fact that visual effects have given us the opportunity to make the kinds of things we could never have made 20, 30 years ago. It's an amazing time to make movies, and I'm such a huge fan of Asian cinema. All the way back from when my dad used to take me to the drive-in to see Shaw Brother Kung Fu movies.I've loved it for so many years, and it's so great to be able to fuse Western cinema and Eastern cinema together.
您都看过些什么中国影片呀？
I don't know what the titles are. In English, there's so many. There's Master of the Flying Guillotine, which I'm such a huge fan of. It's one of my favorite movies. It's the one-armed boxer and the one-armed swordsman movies. Anything by the Shaw brothers back in the day, I just love.
而且我看到您在您的电影里边也用了中国的演员，也在中国来拍摄，就这是怎么考虑的呢？您跟中国演员合作感觉怎么样？
One of the things that really drew me to this franchise was the international construction of it that Guillermo del Toro and the writer Travis Beecham created in the first movie. The fact that it was the world coming together.So it felt very natural in this movie to take that even further, to see people from all around the world and all nationalities, all races, all religions. And I knew from the start that I wanted to set the main Shatter Dome in a good chunk of the action in China, because China is such a wonderful global force in filmmaking now.It felt very natural to the story and very natural to the audience. And I loved shooting in China. I absolutely loved working with the Chinese actors, Tian and Max Zhang and Wesley Wong and Lily Ji and all the Chinese cast. They were so wonderful and so friendly and so talented. And I think it really makes the movie better.To have all of these characters, and especially to have a lot of the Chinese characters speaking in their native language, which to me was very, very important to make it feel as authentic as possible.
我们看到第一部非常的成功，那您来接手第二部的时候，会不会特别的有压力？
Oh no, of course I don't. Of course I do. A massive amount of pressure. I'm a huge Guillermo del Toro fan. I loved the first movie.And I want this movie to do very well so the franchise can continue. We have a very good idea of the next movie and hopefully many, many movies after that. So I feel a great amount of pressure, but I'm also very proud of the movie. It's an incredibly fun, entertaining, emotional movie that I think the audience all over the world will really, really enjoy.
好的，谢谢您。我们特别希望这部电影能够大卖，然后也希望您能够继续带给我们更好的电影。您也可以对我们军武的粉丝们说一两句话。
Sure. First and foremost, thank you so much. It's been a real honor. And I want to say to the fans of Pacific Rim in China and across the world, come see this movie. You will have an amazing time. It is so much fun and has such a great positive message.
我们待会儿马上就要请上来的是其中的一位主演、oh. 他叫斯科特·伊斯特伍德哦、oh,
就是演过狂怒的那个
啊演过狂怒的、嗯、对对 对, 对而且他老爸很厉害
啊我知道克林特·伊斯特伍德、嗯、那个荒野大镖客就是那位对非常有名
那我们就赶快把他请过来呗
好 It works Hello
Hello
How are you
你好你好
Pleasure
你好
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 请坐
How are you
非常欢迎您来到这儿。我们之前也看过半小时的这个电影的剪辑的一些精彩的片段，看到了您特别精彩的表演。您在这个电影里边扮演了一个机甲的战士，那为什么会选择要接这部戏，要扮演这个角色呢？它是什么地方特别的吸引你
？Well, I think you know, I'd start by saying that I was a huge fan of the original film.And I thought that the world Guillermo del Toro had created was an incredible world. And, you know, I also thought this character was very similar to me in some ways. You know, I am a pilot in my real life. So I was able to connect with the character. And, you know, at that point I said, I'm in.
您的父亲是一名非常有名的演员，也是一名非常有名的导演啊。其中的一些作品，比如说，《硫磺岛的家书》《父辈的旗帜》，都是我非常喜欢的。那您作为一个有这样 牛逼父亲的演员的话，你会不会感到很大压力？
No, I feel actually, I feel quite blessed to be, you know, have been raised around film, to have, you know, been exposed to it. So I feel very, just very inspired by my father, more than anything.
其实我们对大片背后它怎么拍出来会感兴趣，您是需要长期的对着绿幕去表演吗？会不会对您这个表演会提出更高的难度？
Well, it always tests your acting skills. CGI is, you know, it's always complicated while shooting. You have to use your imagination, so you have to...You know, you have to let your imagination run wild.
比如说呢，能不能举一个例子？比如哪一场戏让您觉得，对你的想象力是一个挺大的挑战，或者说需要你特别注意一些什么特别的地方？
Sure. There's a, you know, in this film, there's a, I can't give away too much, but there's a very big kaiju, and.To have to imagine that, you know, far above these giant Jaegers, to be looking up and to see this mega kaiju, you have to, you know, pretend to really find the details to imagine such a thing.
就在你们拍摄的现场会有真的机甲？或者说有模拟一些机甲的东西在那儿吗？还是完全是凭空去表演的
？Yeah, you know, you have to use a combination of the real sets that they have designed, the practical sets, and the you know, the added CGI that we use as green screen while we're shooting. So.It's actually quite a nice mix between real sets and the CGI. So it's, you know, it helps. I would say about 50-50, 50% real sets and 50% CGI.
您拍过很多电影，那么您在拍这种巨大机甲的电影的时候，在您的心理上和身体上，您是否要提前做一些和拍摄其他电影不一样的准备？
You know, physically, it's very difficult in the suit, in the drive suit, to do some of this action that's required for us, from us. But, you know, it's always, to make a film of this scope, these big films,they're always complicated. They're never simple. They take a lot of people working together as one. So, you know, in that sense, they're the same. But you know, this film, you have you know, giant mechs fighting you know, giant monsters. So I think, you know, kaiju. I think that there's something different about it.
我刚刚得知您还是一名飞机的驾驶员，曾经驾驶过真实的飞机。那么您之前的电影《狂怒》我也非常喜欢，你在里面驾驶坦克，那你对比一下驾驶飞机、驾驶坦克跟你驾驶机甲，哪样你更喜欢？
Wow, that's those are very two different movies. You know, One is a, you know, is a World War II film that is also a very big film in scope. You know, this film is, I think, more fun. It's, you know, when you're anytime you're doing a, you know, a movie about real people and about, you know, an event throughout history that's so...you know, where people have lost their lives, I think that you take a deep care in preparing and making sure you honor all the people that were involved. You know, this film is a fun film, you know, it's a sci-fi, it's fun, so it's a different in tone.
如果要您来跟中国的观众去推荐这部电影的话，您会怎么来推荐？
Oh, this is a multicultural film. It's a global film. And it's a film that no matter where you are, whoever you are, wherever you're from, you can come together and watch this film and have a great time.
从立时间到了，关注我们军武大本营的微信公众号，在后台回复二字就有可能得到我们送出的福利，那就是环太平洋二的电影兑换券一张。这个电影兑换券呀，在全国通用哦，赶快来吧，军武大本营微信公众号。